Hey, hi, Lisa Marie here. And yes, I've had some questions here at the office and thought I would answer that here, kind of like I did up there. It was pretty funny. But the question came up, somebody had said it hurt so much after their surgery to eat or drink. Drink or eat. Actually, I had to back. Oh, let me press go. And I said, well, you know, I use my hands like normal. That's because everything is swollen and your opening is like this big. And then once it heals, you know, then you've got an opening about this big. Well, I'm a visual person, so I thought I would show you kind of what I shared with the people upstairs. After you've had surgery, first of all, you went from a stomach like this, big and ginormous, in your belly, all stretched out, all big. And, or maybe you had a little bit smaller stomach. This might have been how much. The odd thing is our stomachs stretch pretty big, but they aren't as big as our stomach. Our fat, our big old fat stomach that's hanging out is not our stomach. It's the fat cells that have grown and swollen all around all of our organs and all around our insides. So your stomach really, really, I don't care if you're 100 pounds or 500 pounds, your stomach itself is probably not stretched out that big. It's probably only this big. It's about the size of two fists. That's how big our stomach is. Can we put a bunch in there? Yes. Can we stretch our intestines? Yes. But this might be what your stomach was prior to surgery. And this is what it is after surgery. Okay? So if you've had a pouch, an actual pouch made from a Roux-en-Y or a bypass, you have a little pocket that's not quite as big as this. It's about the size of an egg, actually. So it's a little smaller than this. And those of us who've had sleeves, you think you've got something like this. Wrong. You have something like this, except it's longer, depending on how long your stomach is. Your stomach, using the tool that they use, is really only about this big. It's pretty little. Actually, it's about this big. So this is what I used upstairs. I didn't use the balloons. I used straws. Depending on your stomach length, and we all have a different stomach length, depends on how long your new tool is, your tube. It could be short, so the size of two fists or two fingers, which is what I use all the time when I show people. Mine's not quite this long. Mine's just a little over this right here, but it's only about that wide, and truly, it's like this. But if you are a fortunate person who is an adult and has an adult stomach, your stomach itself is probably as long as, they say, not quite your forearm, not quite, it's almost like your shoe size. It's as long as that. So if you look at these straws, can you see this? You could have a normal standard stomach about as long as the pink one. You could have a longer stomach, which makes you feel like your tool is longer or holds more food because it's longer. You could have a youth stomach like me, and it's actually about as long as this, or maybe even as long as the red one. Can you see the difference there? So depending on your body's makeup, the way God made you, and how long your stomach is how big your tool is. But for those of you who've had a bypass and RNY, you only have the little egg, okay? Your intestines are still your intestines. That's the thing. So back to my other thing. Why does it hurt after you've had surgery to even drink water? Well, that's because you went from an opening. Wow, I should have I should have kept one of these. You went from a stomach this big, with all of its openings and everything being natural, okay? Food coming in, stuff coming out, you know, whatever. But after surgery, that circumference of what goes down your esophagus into your stomach and into your intestines is a whole lot smaller. So you've gone from, maybe your esophagus opening here is about like this. Can you see that hole? Pretty big, right? Our throats are just a little bit bigger than that. But once it goes down into where the tube is and the doctor has made the centimeters that it is, not inches, our new tube is about this big. Can you see that? Look, it fits inside this one. Okay? After surgery, you're lucky if your little tube opening is this big. Why is that? Can you see that little hole? That's because everything is so swollen. It's swollen from being cut. It's swollen from having all of the nerves all detached from each other. It's swollen from just the trauma of having a surgery. Okay? And everything being moved around and cut and whacked and then stapled. Hello! Stapling, if you've ever cut your hand or stapled your finger, like I have, what happens? It swells up. When you get an injury and you hurt your leg or your arm or your back, what happens? Those muscles and everything go freak out when they get injured and they swell up. So all your stuff that was all nice and big like this goes, I can't take it. Which is also why some of us hurt a lot on the inside, especially if we've had scar tissue built up from other surgeries or just from our bodies producing it. So you're trying to drink water and you think you're going to be all drinking a big old gulp. Try to put a gulp through that. Cannot do it. It is going to hurt. It is. It's going to hurt. So once you start healing, then you're going to progress, you know, a little bit more. You're going to be able to get a little bit bigger of a swallow in. I am 3 years out and I still cannot gulp. I can't. I used to only be able to take two tablespoons is an ounce. Oh my gosh, my timer's going off and I didn't want to go this long. Two tablespoons is 1 ounce. And I think when I put a mouthful of water in, it's equivalent to 1 tablespoon, not a whole ounce. I think it's 1 tablespoon. And then it takes me 5 swallows to swallow that. Now I can actually take those sips continuously. Oh my gosh. I can take them all at a time or several in a row. My vocabulary today. Anyway, continuously. There you go. But it's because now my opening is bigger. It's not this little tiny one anymore. It's bigger like this. However, I still cannot swallow big, ginormous swallows. And that's fine by me, because then I make it last. Your sleeve surgery is the day after tomorrow. Happy New Year to you. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for you. That's going to be so awesome. So, no, I mean, I get it. You're nervous, and it's scary. Anytime we're going under the knife and the doctors are going to operate. But this is God's way of preserving and protecting our innards and making everything kind of swell up so that it can heal. Which is why sometimes after surgery, if you've only been a hot temperature person or a room temperature person, after surgery, what do they tell you anytime you've ever had any type of an injury? R-I-C-E, rest, ice, compression, elevate. Our innards are kind of the same thing. We need to rest them and we need to ice them. unless you're willing to walk around and put ice on the outside of you, and it's winter and it's kind of cold, you're going to want to drink really cool liquids that are going to go through. But your body's going to react and it's going to say, ah, what are you doing? Oh, that's coolness. It's trying to take down my swelling. And it will go in. If you just take little tiny swallows, you'll be fine. You really will be fine. You put a thing in your mouth and you make that at least 5 swallows or 6, especially at first. Maybe only put a teaspoon of liquid in your mouth. Don't put very much in. It makes it, you're a lot more successful from that. So kind of what I wanted to show you really was that the reason why it hurts right after surgery is because everything is swollen that was all big and ginormous is now little and stretched. It's little inside. You've got a tube little like this until it starts healing and everything starts kind of going back to its natural normal thing. But that's why. It's because everything is swollen very, very tight. And then as it heals, it starts to open up and relax and release. Which is also why when you're first healing, you might feel other aches and pains in other places. The gas hurts that they put in you and it comes like out your shoulder. It's crazy. The other thing is all your other organs, when all your fat cells start shrinking and going down, guess what? They don't have as much cushion as they used to. They're going to get bounced around a little bit. If you saw my video way back when about your butt bone, you start feeling things that you didn't feel before. And that's because now everything has the ability to move around in your body. But I don't want you to think that you're abnormal. I want you to realize that it is very normal if to accidentally take a big swallow or two too soon, early on, and that is okay. But just know it's because everything is swollen and it will go down, it will heal, and you will be able to take normal swallows, still small. You aren't ever going to be able to chug and gulp and do that anymore, and that's just a part of life, and that's okay. So have a great rest of your day. Have an awesome, oh my gosh, I thought it was Friday. It's not Friday. It's New Year's Eve. What? The end of a decade. A new decade starts tomorrow, 2020. Hey, you can either have 2020 vision and envision something for yourself and what you want your future to be and your healthy you, wah, wah, or 2020 can be the best. It could be our roaring 20s. Woohoo! We are going to knock it. We are going to succeed. And we are going to do and be the things that God designed us to be. So you have an awesome day. And you're such a wealth of information. I'm truly blessed to have found you on YouTube and Facebook. Yay! Thank you so much for telling me that, Amy. I really kind of wonder sometimes if it's helping, and I'm glad it is. So I am praying for you. I'm praying for you right now, and I will the rest of the afternoon because your surgery is coming up, and I'm so excited for you. Yay! New life, new health, new everything coming your way. So you all have a great rest of your day. Happy New Year. And I will see you next year. Oh, is that crazy? I'll see you next year. Okay? Bye. Aw, thanks, Gina.